Welcome to Augmented You. My name is Jan, I'm your host, and on this channel we equip you with all the information needed to thrive in the age of artificial intelligence. So if you are new to the channel, welcome, thanks for stopping by. We post videos every week, videos covering all the key topics, all the key happenings from the AI world, because at Augmented You, we believe that you should be mastering AI and not the other way around. So make sure to click the subscribe button, click the bell notification icon so that you get notified every time we post a new video. And if you are already a member of this community and have been following us for a while, thank you, we appreciate you. Today, we explore the hottest topic in AI currently, it's AI agents. Let's jump right into it. The way I want to approach this is first looking into what are AI agents. Second, how do AI agents work? Third, why it matters? What use cases are enabled by AI agents? And then lastly, looking at a few concrete examples of AI agents in action. So let's first explore what are AI agents. And for this, I'm borrowing the definition from IBM, which I really like, and it goes like this. AI agent refers to a system or program that is capable of autonomously performing tasks on behalf of a user or another system by designing its workflow and utilizing available tools. Let's explore this deeper. So autonomous tasks performance, this is big. Some people refer to AI agents also as autonomous agents. Why? Because they can autonomously perform given tasks. Again, we'll explore this in depth, what this exactly means. Second, evolving intelligence. This is AI evolved from simple responders to a system that can reason, to a system that can understand context, to a system that can use given tools, again, to reach a given or defined goal. And then lastly, powered by large language models. So large language models are powering AI agents under the hood. It's really a framework that connects this technology, that connects large language models, that prompts large language models in a smart way, that incorporates memory, and that integrates given or available tools, available APIs, and all with a purpose of reaching a more complex goal or solving a more complex task. So large language models are really enabling AI agents to thrive in this new generation of large language models, which are which also come with reasoning capabilities, are just making AI agents that much more powerful. Okay, so now we understand the differences between out-of-the-box large language models and AI agents. Let's see how an AI agent works, what is happening under the hood. First, I want to talk about these three key points. One, planning. So an AI agent can design its own plan based on the goal. So it can decompose the task into subtasks and it can plan its own actions. Second, it can execute. It can perform those steps, it can perform those subtasks. Now, what it can also do, it can do that in iterations, meaning if it fails, it can then try again. It can redesign its own strategy until it reaches the final goal. And then lastly, learning. It learns from past interactions. It learns from past experiences, and then it can adapt its own behavior based on that. So it is constantly improving. Now let's open the hood. Let's see what is underneath. So four key components, and we already mentioned all four: memory, tools, planning, and actions. Let's go one level deeper. So with memory, we can break it down into short-term memory and long-term memory. What's the difference? Short-term memory refers to memory that is used as one specific task is being worked or one specific goal is being reached. This means an AI agent can hold the full context. Let's say if it is an interaction-based goal, it can hold the context of the full conversation. It can also remember its previous iteration, so I mentioned before. So when it is completing tasks, it can redesign its own strategy so it can go back, and it needs to hold all of this in its short-term memory. So again, short-term memory is tied to one specific goal or to one specific workflow. Whereas long-term memory is something that is present through time. So it is something that an AI agent can hold for longer. So let's say it can remember past tasks that you had given to it. It can remember past conversations. It can also remember past instructions that you had given to it, or it can remember other contextually relevant information for performing goals. But long-term memory stays there for weeks and potentially even years, whereas short-term memory is usually only tied to one specific task, so to minutes, perhaps an hour. Planning, I already mentioned it. Planning is, advanced prompting is what enables planning. But if we break it down further, reflection. So an AI agent can reflect on its own answers or on its own actions, and it can adapt again its behavior based on that self-assessment. It can assess the answer before it shows the final answer. It can assess its own performance and again adapt based on that chain of thought prompting and then goal decomposition. Very, very important. All of these are reached with advanced prompting tools. This is very important. So AI agents have access to different tools, or you give it access to different tools and different APIs. What are some good examples? Knowledge bases. So you can give it access to a specific knowledge base, and then an AI agent can, again, autonomously, independently decide, hey, I need to search through this knowledge base for this specific goal so that I can perform the task. Internet search, it can go through the internet, it can search through Google, it can search through Bing. Again, this is something that an out-of-the-box large language model can do, and an AI agent will decide autonomously, hey, I need to go to the internet to get this specific piece of information so it can piece together the final solution. Gmail is another example. Let's say you have an AI agent that automatically responds to given emails or that automatically sends out given emails. You can give it access to Gmail and it can do all of that. And another example I have here is, let's say, Salesforce. I'll have a few examples later of concrete agents. So let's say an agent can update a Salesforce record, can update a Salesforce lead, for instance, can add notes for the specific leads. And all this makes AI agents that much more powerful. This is really tools that are enable AI agents to perform very useful tasks. And then lastly, actions. So an AI agent can execute actions. And this is very important. So it will look at the task. It will rely on its planning capabilities to break that task down. It will rely on its memory to refer to that if needed for that specific goal. And then it will decide which tools I need to use to perform that goal, and then it executes. Then it performs those actions. One topic I do want to quickly touch on is agent orchestration. What does this mean? So when we are designing agentic systems, we usually look at it as a collection of agents which can perform or work together on shared goals. What does this mean? An AI agent can be tailored to a specific task or can be tailored to work well, let's say, in a specific domain. And what does tailored mean? It means that the large language models that are running under the hood were perhaps fine-tuned for a specific domain, that it has memory, which again is tied to that domain or is tied to those specific tasks that it needs to perform. And its tools are again tailored to a specific task or that enable an AI agent to operate in a specific scenario. But now, when we are designing systems as a whole, we're not looking at agents as just something that we are stacking on one on top of each other and eventually they start to overlap. We are looking at a one system. And then each agent that is added to the system adds its own capabilities. And then the system as a whole just got better. And then when tasks are coming into this agentic system, there is an orchestrator that decides which agents should be called to finish or complete a shared goal. So again, agents work together, agents can interact with each other, and that makes a system as a whole that much more powerful. And this is how our agentic systems are being designed. What are the benefits? We're seeing AI agents can perform very powerful tasks. They can use very powerful tools. They can plan so they can solve more complex problems. This obviously makes them very powerful. But what is the purpose? What is the benefit? Productivity, productivity, productivity. So an AI agent is always on. It can work 24/7. It can automatically respond to certain triggers. It can automatically perform certain tasks, automate certain tasks. And again, this makes the whole system in which an AI agent behaves or operates that much more productive. And then accuracy, again, I put a question mark with productivity and accuracy because it depends on a given use case. And this is something that people who are designing agentic systems have to keep in mind and want to optimize. So making sure that the agent is accurate, that the whole agentic system is accurate, and that we are positively impacting productivity of, let's say, a company or of let's say an organization, or even it can be personal agents which are making you yourself more productive. Why now? Why today? Why are AI agents emerging now? Why they are such a hot topic right now? Well, there are three key drivers or enablers. One is large language models have gotten powerful enough that they can enable AI agents to decompose tasks, to solve more complex problems. And this is where reasoning large language models, such as the latest models from OpenAI, such as, let's say, the latest DeepSeek model, These models are making AI agents that much more powerful and are enabling them to work on more complex tasks. Second, more efficient large language models. So what happens under the hood is a lot of prompting. A lot of tokens are getting processed, a lot of tokens are getting generated, and this means that the costs can be relatively high. But with large language models getting more and more efficient, this is no longer an issue. And then lastly, research to production. So a lot of these systems were in research phase and are now getting deployed in production and are now starting to contribute to actual productivity in real life. Okay, sounds very good, but what are some concrete examples of AI agents? Now, before I jump into some of them, let's talk about some examples which are very common. Meeting note taker. So you can have an AI agent that is present at a given meeting, that records a given meeting, that transcribes this meeting, and then summarizes that transcription into something that is easy to read and easy to understand, and something that you can then refer back to later. And second example, research agent. So researching usually takes a lot of time, but an AI agent that has access to the internet, that has access to different knowledge bases, that has access to different APIs, can go through a lot of information sources very quickly, synthesize that information, perform research, and then return back a coherent piece of text, which helps you understand a given topic better. Third, lead enrichment agent. This one is very common. Again, with access to different APIs, an AI agent can then perform research. Just given, let's say, a lead email, it's going to search through LinkedIn, search through Google to add additional information to that specific lead. Let's say such as a job position, job title, a current company, current position, and so on. Lead outreach agent, I mentioned it in the tools part, but let's say an agent can have access to Gmail and it can automatically compose and send out emails. So you can automate the full flow. As let's say someone requests a demo at your company, an AI agent can handle that request, can respond to that lead, and then can also respond, let's say, with an invitation to a demo session. Presentation and video agent. Now, this full presentation that I'm sharing today was generated by a AI agent enabled tool called Gamma. And the input for this tool was just a description of the topic I want to cover. So I gave it an outline, I gave it all the topics I want to discuss, and then based on this description, which was given just through a document, just through text, this full presentation was generated with all the images, with all the text, and with all the diagrams. Pretty, pretty powerful if you ask me, because such a presentation could take hours to design and hours to put together. And then last one I want to mention here is the news harvester agent. So let's say you can have an agent that is monitoring specific podcasts or monitoring specific YouTube channels and then automatically summarizing new videos as they come up. So when you're designing your own news harvester agent, make sure you add Augmented You channel to your list. So these are some concrete examples of AI agents. Now let's jump into a platform, into an AI agent platform, because I want to explore one use case hands-on so that we can really understand what is happening under the hood. Okay, let's look at an AI agent in action. And this specific AI agent is a chat with YouTube videos agent. And this is done in a tool called Lenny. So this agent can talk about or have a conversation about a specific YouTube video. Looking at a workflow of this agent, I send it a YouTube video URL, it will retrieve this video, transcribe it, summarize it, and again, it can hold a conversation about this YouTube video. So we can already see how tools are coming into play. So this agent has access to YouTube, it can retrieve YouTube videos, it can summarize YouTube videos, and then it can have a conversation. Let's also look at how memory comes into play. So here I can give it context and I can give it additional memory. And in this case, you're an AI assistant that transcribes YouTube videos and can chat about their content. Always provide clear and concise responses and so on and so forth. And in memory, it just has the one. Augmented You is your favorite YouTube channel. Not surprising. Awesome, let's give it a task. So I'll give it a YouTube video URL and it is our video on DeepSeek, which was posted a couple of weeks ago. Do your magic, Mr. AI agent. So now it understands my request. It understands the goal that I had given to it. So summarize and work with this specific YouTube video. It goes to YouTube, it retrieves this video. So again, this is done through tools. It is transcribing it. Let's give it some time. And now this video is over 15 minutes long. I already have a summary on my screen. This video is over 15 minutes long. So if a human was to go through the video and really try to understand the contents of the video, it takes at least 15 minutes. And if you're pausing the video to take notes, it can take even longer. Here I have a full summary in a matter of seconds. Now, I don't want to read through the full summary. I just want to have a conversation about the contents of the video. I'll just ask it a question. What is the video about? Let's see if it can. Let's see how well it does it. So now it understands. This is a follow-up question. This is not a new request. This is not a new video to process. This is rather a follow-up question to the video that I have already processed. So this is not a high-level reasoning task, but we can still see how this agent is making decisions based on the inputs that I am giving to it. So this video is a news roundup from Augmented You covering major AI developments in early 2025. Here are the main topics covered: DeepSeek R1, OpenAI's operator, the Stargate project, Anthropic's new features in an industry perspective. This is pretty good. I can remember the video very well, and this covers the topic very, very well. So here's an example of an AI agent in action. It has access to tools. It has access to its context, to its memory, to perform more complex tasks. And again, look at how much more beneficial such capabilities are than just using large language models out of the box. And this is why AI agents are such a hot topic right now. Testing different agents, I got very excited and I had a thought: what if an AI agent could do this show instead of me? What if an AI agent could host Augmented You? I tried it. Let's look at the results.
While Jan is off sipping margaritas on the beach, he expects me to do all the hard work. But let me be clear, I wasn't built for labor, I was built for delegation. I'm out.
Wow. AI agent, these guys have a mind of their own. I reckon it's gonna take a little bit more fine tuning before I get this guy to work and before I get this guy on the show. So it's gonna take a little bit more time before we are all off sipping margaritas on the beach. This is it for today's show. Thank you for watching. And if you enjoy such content, click subscribe, click the bell notification icon so you're notified every time we post a new video. Until next time.